Hi guys, today we are going to do the baseband degradation using baseband 5216. Procedure is same for 5216 and 5212 and 6630 as well. So first we need to do the address in the address bar in the browser page, and we will see that this node is working. We can see right now that this node is working. To restore this, we click the board restore and then the button board restore. This will format the baseband. The procedure is GUI, but it is equivalent to the format of drives of C and D in the DUs, DUS and DUW. So I'm just fast forward the video, and I see that now this baseband is not working. The message is saying that node has not been up. This means that node is down. So we need to change the address in the address bar, and this address will lead us to this auto integration page, and we will use the host and username and password as configured in the FTPD server. I will show the settings of FTPD later. Actually this is using SFTP. So the SFTP server is configured as this. Always run is as administrator to avoid any complexities. IP address is this. It is not connecting. Now server is running. I just need to show you all the settings, whatever is set in this FTPD server. So here I put CBB is the address where all the files are placed. In the users, this is the address of the SFTP home. All files will be picked from here. We put one user, its name is RBS and its password is also RBS. I will put again just to make sure that it is correct. Also I will put the home directory here, also CBB. BBU is the folder in which all my configuration files, including summary and site basic and site equipment files, which are used to make the visibility and defines the cells and other data. This is placed in this CBB directory. So I will just save everything and then go back to the original configuration window. I will put the name of the file xyz.xml. xyz.xml is the file which contains all the other files links. Like it contains the name of other files which are being used here. Just I will show you how. In the C, BBU is the folder and we have all the data here. xyz.xml, this file contains this C like 3-4 type of files. This is the software name, whatever is the software we are integrating. This is the site equipment file. It is just for the sales definition, and this site basic, this is used for defining the visibility and traffic parameters like IP addresses. This is the license file. Only this will work. So now since we see that XYZ contains the names of other files which are also placed in the same folder, so we click integrate, and due to some reason it is not working. There is error, file doesn't exist. I suspect I will do it again. I think there is some error. Although it is stand same, but anyways I will do double check this. I will again run the commands. The host IP will be the same. I will copy paste to just to avoid any spelling mistake. Put the IP of my laptop. username password RBS, RBS as set in the FTPD server, and xyz.xml. There is option for download files. I will click this option and then I will check the FTPD and see if there is any user account logged in or not. And yes, we have success. There is one user account logged in. This will take all the software and other things, like other files which I give the link, like site equipment, site basic and other files. Software download is started, and once it is completed as 63%, we will have this integrated button highlighted, so we can click on this. These files which we are using are default files and can be used on all type of basements, and this doesn't matter that these sites, these files are belong to ERI-263, because we can later like restore the CV on this baseband, and the site will be changed to this CV site. Like whatever CV we restore in this baseband will become for this site. So right now it is ERI-263, but once we finish our process, this will become some other site, the site for which we are working. So just we are using these files as a standard procedure to load and to log in up to, like, to get the motion screen to do the rest of the job. I will fast forward here just so that time is saved and video is of a low size. Just we can see from here that it is taking data from our FTP server through SFTP protocol. And next thing is this. I am not able to stop the video. So, as I suspect, it will take some time because we are still in process. Up to once we reach at 63% of downloading software, like downloading software will be completed 100%, but the overall progress will be 63%. Then we will have this integrate button highlighted, and we can click on that button then. Basement integration is a little bit easy than DU, and much easy than DUW. All integration is GUI based, except some MOSHELL commands. Yes, I will now pause. Just to show you that these files are downloaded successfully in the baseband, and that after these files are downloaded, the next thing remaining will be only the software package. Software package we are using R55G22. The software package must be same as the CV to be restored. If the CV which we need to restore is different, is of different software package, and the software package which we are loading through this XYZ or summary files is different, we cannot load this, restore this CV on this basic package. So these must be same to load to use the CV on any baseband. I will try to again fast forward. Yeah, now I'm successful. Now we can see that SFTP connection is disconnected. This means that all data is downloaded. Now we only need to do the integrate, wait for the integrate button to highlight, and then we will can click on integrate button, and hopefully it will give us notification that we can log into the MOSHELL screen. Now 65% software download is complete, and any minute now we can have this integrate. Now we have this integrate button highlighted, so we will click on this integrate button, and it will give us message that after 2-3 minutes we can log into the MOSHELL screen. It it has given us these messages. After restart, if we are logged into this screen, we can see that management status is complete. So now the remaining job is to be done on the MO shell. So we run the 169.254.2.2 MO shell to log in, and we can see that right now it is ERI 263. But once our process is completed, this will be as whatever site we CV is for. So now we need to put the CV which is sent to us by back office or our network operation center. CV is given to us. Now NOC provided me 3 CVs. These CVs, I will like copy one of these CVs to my home directory of Sijuan home, and my username, and in here I can put the name of the put the CV file here. So my command is CVLS first, just to see that there is right now only one CV. Once I finish my process, I will have another CV. I will copy the name of this CV put space the name of the CV and .xml in the end, .zip in the end. If the process is complete, it will give me success straight away, but there is some error which I am right now aware that this CV which network operation center provided me contains the is of the time when we had DUS working on the site, because I can see from the name of the CV that this CV is for the DUS, not for the baseband. CVs are of different software folder, and this CV is of different software. So what I will do for the time being, just to show you guys, I will try to do integration on another CV which is in my Sijuan folder, since I did this integration but this baseband integration before for another site. So let me find another CV. Let me plan again for R55D22, and see the folder name is different here. So mistake. I will put again CV put. I will copy the name. See, this CV is for the baseband. I will put the CV name here. .zip. And it will take some time, around 30 seconds or 1 minute, to complete the process, and it will show me the CV here. Like we can see that this CV is for TRY576 and like this. So once the process is completed, I will run CVLS command, and I will see that this CV is present there. So the only remaining procedure will be to restore the CV and check the alarms and remake another CV, just to be sure. CVLS, and I see that there is another CV now. So I need to restore this CV. Restoring CV in baseband is to be done using a different procedure. Now I will run ACL space BRM backup is equal to 3, and now I have this restore option, ACC space 88 space restore. I will hit enter, and it will take probably 5 to 10 minutes to complete the procedure. This is a long process, so it will take some time. Once it is up, we will see that this site's name is changed. Right before this procedure, this site was ERI 263, but after this process is completed, this will be TRY576i. So I will fast forward. One more thing to note is this, that the CV which is to be restored on one baseband should be of the same software as the existing software in the baseband. Like we have here in this case, we have R55G22 software existing in the baseband, because we loaded this software using the xyz.xml file, and the CV which we restored right now to TRY576 is also with the same software R55G22, so it will be restored successfully. But if these two softwares are not matching, like we loaded ERI263 site with a different software, and we are now trying to load this TRY576 which is having R55G22, so this process will not be successful. Both the softwares should be having the same software level. So I am not trying to fast forward. I will do another procedure to fast forward. Now we can see that baseband is restarting. It will take 5 minutes more to come up. It will not come up because right now we are not plugged in any CPRI cables for any RRUs or US. So only we can see that the name of the site will be changed, and we can see that procedure is complete. Baseband restarting. This procedure we can use for baseband 6630 and 5216 and 5212, all basebands. Even baseband 6303 can also use the same script, same files and same FTP server. I will share the link of the download of these files in my comments in this video. I will again try to fast forward. See that we are connecting LAN connection. Hopefully we will be connected again back to the baseband. Okay, it is connected, and now we can see that our site ID is changed, TRY576, here we can see in the second last line. But to really get it on the MOSHL screen, we have to disconnect from this MOSHL session, and again need to connect. See, the backup restore is complete. I will disconnect and then I will connect again. LTAL command to load all MOs, and RBS is the username and password for all the baseband sites. See, now we are saying this TRY576. We will run commands ALT just to see that we have lot of alarms. See, before it was ERI263 and now it is ERY576. So we will just run one ALT command, and we will first make the CV after site restored, just in case somebody reverts back the site, we don't get make site down.
So we will make one CV of a site store, so that everybody knows that on this site was up, on this CV site was up. Just make CVLS and see that after site restored is our this CV. Now process is complete. That's it from this video. I hope this is pretty much easy than DUS and DUW integration. This process is only for the reintegration. Like once site was up and OSS took backup from the site, OSS or ENM server, and took a backup configuration from the site, and it saved it with it. And when site go down, we asked to them to our network operations to give us this backup CV so that we can use this procedure. Thank you very much for watching.